Hello, Chris Menard. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video in Excel, we're going to look at the value function. We will also cover the T function and the multiply by one. The issue is we have a lot of text that actually should be numbers or dates. I'm going to go ahead and show the value function right now. I run into this a lot. Over in column C, whenever I download data from Microsoft, it frequently shows up this way. I do want to point out that it got left aligned, so that's one way to know that it's text. Here's the biggest way. If you go and highlight this column, column C, look down in the bottom right corner, my status bar shows count and it shows 1444. That is letting me know that all of this is text. Because if it was true numbers and I have true numbers in column I, when I select column I still see count of 6. I know that I1 is text. But look at next to it is my numerical count, and it's got the number 5. Same thing here with these actual dates. When I select them, same as those numbers, the count 7 and the numerical count is 6. So those are truly dates. One other way is to go to Data tab and turn on your filters, hit the filter arrow. If you've got true dates, it will display the years if you have multiple years. If I come over here to column C, turn on filter, hit the drop down, it is not showing me the years here, so I know that this is text. So here you go, the value function. I need to convert those to dates, equal value. It is telling you what this function does. It converts a text string that represents a number to a number. Tab, put in cell C2, press enter. Perfect, dates are numbers. January 1, 1900 is the number 1. January 2nd, 1900 is the number 2. So just autofill this down. And then you want to make sure you copy and paste the values. I'm just going to right click and drag it over. I could right click and copy and paste values, but here's copy, here's values. And there you go, it picked up the date formatting. If it didn't, you would have gone to the Home tab and selected short date. Let's see if this worked. Actually, it didn't do it for these. Let me do this real quick. Highlight, home, short date works. You could do long date. It's up to you. Now, hit the drop down and look. There are the 4 years I have in here. I can filter this. I can sort it. When it was text, I could not. You don't need column E anymore, so you can right click and delete it or clear the contents, whatever you want to do. Now, a bonus tip. That was the value function. I'm going to undo a couple times. If you want to do this another way, here we go. You can just type the number 1, press enter, click back on it, and copy it. Highlight column C, and you want to go to paste, paste special, and we're going to do a multiply. I'm multiplying by the number 1, hit OK, still selected, and go to short date. I use both the number 1 multiply trick and the value function. I use them both. You should know both of them. One other item, this is a bonus tip. If you run into numbers and text mixed, and I've got it right here, I'm going to highlight column H. My count is 6. My numerical is 4. That means I've got one extra field in here. Let's insert a column. You can use multiple ways to do this, but one easy way is to use the T function, equal T, H2, I should get a blank because that actually is a number, 5432. Double click. If something appears, that is letting you know that that is text and not a number. If I get in here, I'm like, maybe they typed a O instead of a 0, and that was the answer. Select, it is correct down below in the status bar. I'm going to delete this column here. Last item, if you ever have numbers that show up as text, sometimes Excel will help you out with a green triangle. If these should actually be number, hit the drop down, convert to number, but that doesn't always appear. I'm just letting you know that's why I showed you value and multiply by number 1. My Excel online training courses are available. Also, I have online training in Teams, OneNote, and Copilot. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful day.